So, JL, what is your position on fracking, the practice of forcing
fracking.
Pressurized fluids commonly into shale to extract natural gas?
Well, fracking is actually a very bad idea because we have water tables that we depend on, and it's a scientific fact that, it's a common sense fact. Once you start shaking the ground and shooting chemicals down into the ground to bring out oils, you're polluting the water table. And for that reason alone, I would outlaw it personally, because it's water is the key to survival, and if we destroy our water system, we have nothing.
So, but they're saying that natural gas will be our savior to maybe bridge the gap between oil and some other fuel source. Do you not see it as that type of bridging device?
Oh, natural gas is our bridge, or one of the bridges. But natural gas already exists. The wells are already in existence. We don't need to frack to pull oil or natural gas out of shale or other minerals into the rock formations. They already exist. We have enough, even going with the systems that are in place by, the name escapes me. There are systems in place, programs in place, just waiting for government approval, and I believe that would make a great bridge to take us off of the oil system, depending on oil, or the national dependence on foreign oil, so to speak. But unlike Harry, I do believe that we should drill while we're making the transition to hydrogen base, or my automobile is a nitrogen base. Same difference. We do need a bridge, and natural gas is the bridge, but fracking is out of the question. We can have all the oil, all the natural gas in the world, but if we don't have water, we're not going to exist to drive those automobiles or power those factories.
Okay. Harry, do you want to give a minute to rebut?
Well, I completely agree with John. Fracking should be outlawed, Judy. It's important for people to understand that fracking involves injecting hundreds of highly toxic chemicals deep into the earth. And there's this physics process that apparently most people aren't aware of. It's called diffusion. It's like pouring cream into coffee. It's a very rapid reaction, as you know. And when you pour poison into that cup of coffee, it diffuses just as fast as the cream. And this is why we have these poisons in our blood and in our children's blood, and why we have epidemics of cancer and heart disease and deformed children whose nervous systems have been seriously damaged before they're even born. This should be illegal, all right? These people involved in this business should be arrested and tried as the criminals that they are, except it's perfectly legal to do this because their oil company and gas company lobbyists got all of these toxic chemicals made legal.
Okay, I want to stay on this topic because a lot of people think that the fracking industry is going to create a lot of jobs. Why don't you touch on this, JL?
Oh, fracking creating jobs. Actually, drilling for oil creates more jobs than fracking. And that's from the supply side to the delivery side to the secondary and third economies that need to supply the new employees. Much like manufacturing, fracking involves a small team of union employees fracking, drilling, fracking, blasting out nothing because they don't pull anything out by the amount of poisons they pump into the ground.
Harry, I just read an article about fracking that two brothers living on or owning the same land were kind of in disagreement over whether they should lease their land out to the fracking companies, and one was saying, "Oh, I think it must be safe. They wouldn't go in unless it were." Why don't you touch on this dilemma?
Well, it's a global contamination problem that's already well underway, Judy. And you have to, and I cite Sanjay Gupta, who's a professor of medicine and a senior correspondent for CBS News and CNN News. He did a 2-hour documentary who pointed out every man, woman, and child not only in this country, but on this planet, have now been heavily contaminated with tens of thousands of these poisons. This is the poison business. Yeah, you can create jobs, but the question is, how much poison and how many people do you have to poison to create those jobs? If we go to a solar hydrogen energy system, which is what I'm proposing, if we started immediately, we don't poison anyone or anything, and it is the only way to clean up all of the toxic air that we breathe every day in our cities. It's the only way to clean up the poison we put in the waters is to stop making it, and oil is the source of this poison. And natural gas is equally toxic. None of these are clean energy sources. I don't care what President Obama or the other Republicans say. If we had a fair accounting system, and if the scientists and medical doctors were had any say in any of this, it would be highly illegal to poison innocent people by the millions, which is what we are now doing with this addiction to fossil and nuclear fuels.